It's the NVL show. Where's the table? What are they doing? You never expect the expected with the NVL show. You expect one thing, boom, something else, entirely different. Interview? No. Sofa.
You never expect the expected.
You can't. You literally can't.
You don't know what's coming.
You have no idea what's coming. So here we are, sat on a sofa. This week, due to, what's the phrase?
Laziness.
No, laziness. Popular demand. And abject laziness. We have decided to bring back Rewrite, where we bought ESPN 2K5 and we drafted the throwbacks and we made two episodes. And I said, Chris, what do you think of this? And Chris went, well, we haven't got anything else this week, so let's do that. So we brought it back. And so here you go. NVL Rewrite. Get on board. It's chock-a-block full of personal jokes.
Rewrite. When the crowd say bo.
Rewrite. I'm feeling pretty good about San Diego Drew Brees, despite the fact his arm's made out of Lego. And blown core. Wow, this game's realistic.
Crowd's going crazy.
Benton! Right! Benton!
Aloha, I'm Chris Berman.
So I had this crazy idea. ESPN 2K5 is indisputably the greatest American football game of all time. So why don't I buy a PS2? Why don't I buy ESPN 2K? And why don't I create the NVL throwbacks and fill the roster with the greatest players of all time? Would I be able to take this brand new franchise and turn them into a contender? Could we go back in time and stop the Patriots dynasty from even happening? Could I try this whole thing once and then go back and re-record it because the first time the audio was terrible? The answer to these questions is I don't know, but we're gonna find out. Welcome back to Rewrite. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to NVL Rewrite. It's been about a year since we've done one of these, and this week we're going to recap all the episodes we did. So we're going to see the draft, we're going to turn the fantasy draft roster on, we're going to customize the league so that the NVL throwbacks are going to have their own team, and all the other teams are going to have all the brilliant players that played for them in 2004-2005. Terrell Owens on the Eagles, Chad Pennington on the Jets, Tim Rattay on the San Francisco 49ers. So this is how the fantasy draft shook out. I took a young Drew Brees, so young he still has his mole. Drew's going into the fourth year of his Hall of Fame San Diego Chargers career. I could have taken Eli Manning, Ben Roethlisberger, Philip Rivers, all rookies in this draft, but I'm feeling pretty good about San Diego Drew Brees, despite the fact his arm's made out of Lego. Backing up our QB with one arm, we've got a QB with one brain cell.
Here is Rex Grossman. Is that a good start?
It's my quarterback.
And then a man we appear to have signed for the rest of his career, Matt Schaub, aka the Demon Headmaster. Running backs by committee, we're going to be riding the hot hand in a backfield of lukewarm hands. We've got Willis McGahee and his chicken leg. We've got Julio Jones's evil twin brother, Julius Jones. And Steven Jackson, who was in this really cool Nike advert. I mean, the dude's a battering ram, no pun intended. Where do you start with this fever dream of a wide receiver room? You've got Dennis Northcutt, a man famous for getting toasted by an ostrich. Andre Johnson, the only one in danger of catching a ball, but he's too busy throwing hands. Then the longest name ever to grace a jersey.
TJ Hoshimazoud, yes, lock it up.
Who?
What? TJ How's Vanilla? Alright. TJ, who's your mama?
NFL.com Fantasy Rule 17. Know how to pronounce your draft picks.
You mean TJ Hushmanzada from the Bengals?
Put him on the board. Hoshimazoud, got it. Championship.
And then this guy.
Give it up! Huh! It's your boy, Nate B.
I like this.
To make up for that, we're pretty stacked at tight end. We've got Algie Crumpler, and he knows how to hang on to a ball.
Crumpler, what a throw, what a hit, what a catch. Vicious ball from Brian Dawkins.
You got knocked the fuck out, man.
And then we've got old man Shannon Sharp. Who is doing these contracts? Jeff Saturday, front and center.
I'll knock you out.
Rookie Vince Wilfork, who played his college ball at Burger King. Jaden Smith, Willow Smith. Lance Briggs, a beast in the middle, and
Jesus Christ.
96 rated Brian Urlacher doing this. Johnny Vilmer, the rookie, doing this.
Oh.
And then D'Angelo Hall, doing this.
Fuck you, and fuck you, I'm out.
And I guess this guy's pretty good too. Waiting deep in the backfield, we've got the half man, half beast, the meast, Sean Taylor, coming straight out of Miami U, wearing 36, he's so young. Favourite story about this clip is that Brian Moorman still has his Pro Bowl jersey hung up in his house because it still has Sean Taylor's helmet paint embossed onto it. Imagine a backfield of Brian Dawkins and Sean Taylor, it's not fair. Brian Dawkins, where have I heard that name before?
Vicious ball from Brian Dawkins.
You got knocked the fuck out, man!
Oh yeah. Kicking for the throwbacks, you've got Neil Rackers, a man who will ding four consecutive balls off the uprights and still ask you to pick him.
Pick me.
That's not really how kicking works, Neil. And then punting the pigskin, you've got everyone's favourite uncle and God's only son, Brian Moorman. Where have I heard that name before? Oh yeah.
Jesus Christ.
So there you have it, we are up to speed on everything we did a year ago. We've got our team, we've got our jerseys, we've got Sean Taylor in the backfield. Can we stop the Patriots from winning the Super Bowl? Will Janet Jackson get her tit out again? Who knows? But what we do know is we've got a quarterback controversy on our hands.
Quarterback playing or not?
Who? Rex Grossman?
Yeah.
You like Rex Grossman?
I love him, Mr. Unpredictable. He's like he's a train wreck with balls.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying what side of the controversy I'm on, but to deny that there's a quarterback controversy is ridiculous.
Well, I don't think this is a story that we can just brush off.
Listen, this is my job, so I don't care who they bring in.
It starts to create havoc in the locker room because they're just not happy with it.
This is my team. This is my job. I'm the quarterback of this team. People tried to make that an awkward situation mm-hmm. between mm-hmm. us.
He can be a very, very good quarterback, and he can read defenses.
I think both guys can help our team. Why do you continually try to get me to say something that doesn't respect one of them? I'm not going to, so quit asking.
There'll be a quarterback that'll be named next week that'll be the starter. There's three quarterbacks in this football team. Whichever one starts, starts. Whichever one don't, we'll back him out. Period. Cut and dry. It's nobody's concern but ours. Nobody's. Next.
I mean, it's not really a quarterback controversy, is it? Because we're picking between Drew Brees, Brew Drees and his jelly arm, and Sexy Rexy, a man biologically designed to throw interceptions. I mean, it's not like we're picking between Cam Newton and Taylor Heinicke in its prime. So we've got our QB, which is good because the Jaguars have got theirs, serial overthrow artist and OG Jameis Winston, Byron Leftwich. Byron struggled to grasp the playbook and wasn't exactly an offensive mastermind, leading to him playing for 5 teams in a 9-year NFL career. I'm not exactly sure what he's doing, oh, for f***'s sake. Backing up Mind of His Generation Byron Leftwich, you've got one of the only other names you'll recognize from the entire history of the Jaguars franchise.
Here's the handoff to Taylor, looking for some cutback. He finds some room, look at Fred go. He's across the 30, look at him run! Fred's going! He's at the 50, the 40, they won't stop at 30, 20, 10, 5, touchdown! 80 yards, Fred Taylor!
So, week 1, Jacksonville Jaguars versus the discount Dallas Cowboys.
Jacksonville Jaguars, it's game time!
So, haven't played this for about 10 years, better get used to the whole tackling, I think it's X. Good start. I think for ease of watching, you're probably better off ignoring the players I'm controlling completely. Fred Taylor with a first down, clearly, but bring out the chain, sure, why not? And blown call. Wow, this game's realistic.
Crowd's going crazy.
No!
For a man I picked up in the 8th round, I think Julius Jones is starting to find his sea legs. Wait, nah, scratch that. Big old kick from Brian Moorman.
I thought for a second he was going to run it then. Wait, hang on, why's the music changing? Is something bad going to happen?
No! God! No! God, please, no! 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 No!
Yes, I probably need to learn how to tackle, but these are Hall of Fame players tackling like Shamarco Thomas running the 40. Fred Taylor essentially got his cock and balls out and rubbed it in the face of my entire team. Like Chris Jones running the 40. Yeah, but you were running so fast, nobody saw. So 7-0, we're looking for a miracle. Enter Julius Jones.
Turn down for weed.
Alright, that's enough. So, 7-7, nothing much happens in the next few series apart from each quarterback getting put in the ground like a pot plant, leaving Ronnie O'Rackers to pot the black in the middle pocket, which he does. 10-7.
Pick me.
I already did. Stop asking. Byron Leftwich has a quick go at being Tom Brady before my defense rearranges his flower garden all over again, leaving Josh Scobie to squeak one over the bar. Eep. There we go. 10-10.
1 minute to go until the half. Nothing's going to happen. Right?
Gates. Plenty of time.
I think my favourite part about this game is actually the crowd.
And we are storming into the second half. There's some stellar QB play on display, and Fred Taylor does his best impression of Fenton.
Hand off to Taylor, looking for some cutback. He finds some room, look at Fred go.
Fenton! Oh, Jesus Christ! Fenton!
Which leaves Josh Scobie to squeak one inside the post. Eep, there we go, 17-13. Brian Dawkins has been training at the Marcus Williams School of Tackling.
Bruh.
No! All leaving Fred Taylor averaging 17.2 yards per carry, the score at 2017, and the throwbacks in need of a miracle.
Drew Brees will get his chance. In great field position, no timeouts left. That miss is so big on so many levels.
Listen, this is my job, so I don't care who they bring in. This is my team, this is my job. I'm the quarterback of this team.
Brees over the middle. What a grab! They've got to hurry. 15 seconds left, no timeouts. Can they get the spike down in time? They do! With 6 seconds to go and now 5 seconds to go.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to show you a little something I've been working on. We're going to take these first two balls and hit them off the left upright. And we're going to take the next two balls and hit them off the right upright.
You need a kicker, right? Pick me. Pick me. Pick me.
Oh, he hits the upright. It's no good. How in the world?
Things didn't get much better for the throwbacks in the next game. For their home opener at the Stardome, the media had put enough pressure on the coaching staff to bench Drew Brees in favour of Sexy Rexy, which, well, you know, went as badly as you could probably imagine. Julius Jones couldn't find his sea legs again, and Neil Rackers kicked about as badly as Chris Boswell or Wayne Rooney's Street Striker, which all led Greasepipe Joe to hit Mr. Disney in the corner for a touchdown. One consolation score in the fourth quarter to keep Julius Jones' fantasy owners happy, all three of them, and then Rex Grossman sends all the home fans into the car park with a kick in the dick that is two revolting interceptions. Go on, throw another one.
We couldn't throw, we throw in interceptions, it just, man, it.
Well, what happened was that second game, we got our ass kicked. We couldn't do diddly poo offensively. We couldn't make a first down. We couldn't run the ball. We didn't try to run the ball. We couldn't complete a pass. We sucked. The second half, we sucked. We couldn't stop the run. Every time they got the ball, they went down and got points. We got our ass totally kicked in the second half. That's what it boiled down to. It was a horse performance in the second half. Horse.
The players are angry. The coaches are angry. The locker room is a complete disarray.
Don't talk to me, all right? Knock it off!
And it's hard to see where the throwbacks go from here. 0-2, and facing the New York Football Jets next week. Chad Pennington, Curtis Martin and the gang, who are so confident they spent the entire week's run-up to the game bullying Elmo on his own street.
Chad, Chad, over here, over here!
Go along, Elmo, go along!
You know what word I love? I love the word prepared.
Well, you aren't prepared for the throwbacks, Chad. We'll be right back.